able to sit in front of the people like, you know, Mr. Bedi and Mr. Balik, you know. So it's very, very important part for any photographer, you know, to come and join these kind of workshops, actually lift up the spirits and you learn things here. So today's presentation, if we just go through, can we just change? Yeah, I think better I will go there, yeah. So today's our main focus of area, like what we have shortlisted for you guys, because more of the photographers, yahan pe jitne bhi ganmanya vyakti ya log jitne bhi hain, wo sare professional photography ya us cheez se related उस एरिया से बिलोंग करते हैं. तो वी हैव शॉर्टलिस्टेड सम ऑफ द फीचर्स विच आर वेरी यूजफुल एंड न्यू टेक्नोलॉजीज डेवलपिंग एंड डूइंग वंडर्स इन शॉर्ट कमिंग ऑफ टाइम ड्यूरेशन लाइक कैमरा लाइक यू नो वाईफाई फीचर्स दिस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स वी हैव शॉर्टलिस्टेड एंड ऑफकोर्स वी वॉन्ट टू शोकेस प्रोडक्ट लाइनअप आवर लिटिल बिट प्रोडक्ट लाइनअप बट वी हैव द टॉप लेवल प्रोफेशनल कैमराज टू द सेमी प्रोफेशनल कैमरा विच कैन डू वंडर्स एंड यू कैन शूट फिल्म. वी हैव सम वीडियो क्लिप्स ऑल्सो to showcase you that जहाँ पे एक छोटा कैमरा बहुत स्मॉल इक्विपमेंट के साथ आप एक बहुत अच्छी फिल्म बना सकते हैं. सो आगे बढ़ते हुए ये हमारी कुछ लाइनअप है स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम D4S जो हाई एंड मॉडल में बात करें स्पोर्ट्स के लिए जर्नलिज्म के लिए AFP PTI जो बड़े बड़े गेटी इमेजेस बड़े बड़े न्यूज एजेंसीज हैं दे आर दी पीपल हु आर यूजिंग दिस काइंड ऑफ कैमरा. देन वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग कैमरा D810 आई थिंक चित्रांश गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू दैट what is the new invention we have done in this field. Then of course DA10 very popular amongst all the fashion photographers and people who need a high resolution images. Of course 750 is good for the journalism and any kind of photography. It's one of the versatile camera we ever produced till date. Then people who like to shoot still and want to have a feel of retro styling like your FM3, you know, your F2. I am a very brought up in the same lineup. So FDF is those people who like to shoot like similar kind of body profile like they used to have in FM2, FM3 type. Then of course we have a D610. It's the lightest and cheapest full frame DSLR available till date market. And of course we will showcase first time the D7200 which is recently launched. We have a very nice AV to showcase that way also. So these are some product lineup we have recently. So the D4S is the 11 frames per second. So if anybody who's from the sports photography or any journalism people, they would understand why it's more important. Because 11 frames per second, you can shoot continuously with the full frame. And at the same time, you can write that file. See, shooting is not an easy thing to do. But us image ko process karne ke liye bhi aapko ek processor chahiye, jo ki aapki 11 frames per second. For example, I was very lucky enough to shoot a 100 meter race with the last Olympic Games. So I have a 10 second. The world's the biggest event, I would say, it's a 100 meter race. I have done that camera, set into the camera, and I have shot continuously with this D4S. I've got, end of the 10 seconds, I have 110 images to choose from. Like each and every action, each and every moment. So that kind of capability, that kind of image quality, this camera can continuously provide, and for a longer time, long duration. So this is the kind of thing you can see, what kind of images we achieve with this. The next lineup is D810. D810 is the highest megapixel count, 36 megapixel count, and very useful for fashion, where people, architecture, product photography, people require a holding to make printouts. Or it's basically depends on the, I heard somebody was asking about the megapixel myth, like people who need megapixel, they would love this camera to have it because they have to print out and they have to give huge assignments, like if the fashion photography, if they say, or aap koi product photography kar rahe, wahan pe you need a big resolution file. So this actually compensate the medium format camera. Aap logo medium format camera use karne ki zarurat nahi hai if you don't have assignments, you know, to shoot. So this is one of the good cameras we have. So there are some features like 36 megapixel ISO range starts from 64. So till date, no camera, digital camera, has an ISO range from 64. We have started from 100 to 200, but now this camera provides you the shoot from 64 ISO. So it's again, and then of course expanded to 12,800, which is a very high ISO. Easily can be done. Any kind of dark scenes also can be captured. Of course, it can, this camera also capable of shooting video 60p, which is slow motion. We'll talk about in a later stage what all things we have done with the D810. And of course, it's a full frame camera. So this is a small example of what being a high megapixel camera, it also retains the details in very, very high ISO nodes. So this is the image if you see. So you can see this, like a 3200 ISO and the 12,800 ISO is looks like a similar thing. So this is the kind of flexibility you have if you want to shoot dark scenes, landscapes, any kind of places, or astrophotography. We have a dedicated astrophotography camera we launched. So these are all examples for the why this camera is beautiful. This is again one more example. This is one shot. So if I crop it. This is the kind of resolution you have. Some of the time, photographers shoot a frame of mind, like a one shot. Like for example, journalism also. Aapka ek shot liya, journalism mein aapne socha ki ye picture mereko pura chahiye. Maan lijiye kuch aisa impact hua, you need that a small crop from the that frame. You have an option to do that. The next camera is a more versatile camera we have, D750, where frame rate, megapixel is a combination, and we have done very good flexible balance for speed and ISO performance. So this camera has a very, very good features, similar like a D810 video features. You can see the LCD also, which is very useful for taking pictures of a low angle, high angle, you know. Some of the images I can show, very, very high ISO. 12,800 ISO is generally considered to be very high, and you can see the details. This camera is very special. We recently launched, people who like to shoot astronomy photography, stars, stargaze, this is the camera for them. So I would like to hand over to Chitransh. Please, Chitransh, can you just move off?
Thank you. Thank you, Ashwin-san. Please, effects format and DX format. Sir, I'll do that.
I'll do that.
Thank also, you. We'll have a brief question and answer session after this as well.
Good afternoon, everyone. Recently launched D810A, which is A is a small tweak in D810. Now we have the camera which can register the H alpha rays, which are especially from distant galaxies. So we can now register the H alpha rays, the magenta color of that H alpha rays. Now our camera is 4 times more sensitive to that H alpha rays. So it has 656 nanometer, the wavelength of the light, which is traveling from the distant, very distant, like 100 light years. So we can now register that images. Also, this camera have the maximum exposure of 900 seconds, which is 15 minutes. So you can keep on your shutter open for 15 minutes so that you can register the smallest light available in the night sky. So for this camera, you can shoot astrophotography, you can shoot galaxy photography, you can even have the equatorial head, which is has the same speed of revolving with the same speed of Earth, so that you can avoid the star trails. Right. And also now we have D7200, like Ashwin-san, can I? Sir. This, at the back, it's a sample picture. So earlier, sir, we used to get green color. Now, this camera is tweaked to get the magenta color of that. Can you see the back, the magenta color? That's a special H alpha rays. So now we have D7200. There's a small AVN. After that, I'll ask Ashwin-san to like sound, please. Lights.
Lights dim color, please. Thank you.
So this is the latest addition to our lineup, D7200. The complete picture, the complete movie is shot on D7200.
Okay, why so different? I mean, we see this is a DX format camera. Sir was asking about the FX and DX format camera. The FX format, it's an equivalent full frame, like we used to have our films, the Kodak films, we used to have any 35mm film. So that's the size of all D810, D4S, DF, D610, D750. These are the cameras which are actually the cameras, you know, equivalent to the that size. This camera, is we are saying it's one of the our lead flagship model for the DX format. DX format is an APS-C sensor, a small film we used to have, and we have a D90, very popular camera if everybody knows, D90. So this is like the very, very upgraded model, we can say. This camera provides to shoot, you can shoot time-lapse. You must have seen the images, some footage, very nice footage for time-lapse. This camera can shoot some of the very, very important video features like a flat picture control. You can do color gradation, like with the any color gradation you want to do, it's possible with the post-production. And all the features which are there in the D8, the top of line, it's available in this camera. Also, camera has the D750 and the D8, D7200 has a Wi-Fi feature. Now Wi-Fi, we know all that Wi-Fi has doing a lot of good things for us. Like right now also we are accessing to check the emails and everything. Similarly, the image-wise, for example, one photographer is sitting here and immediately the editor wants the image to be sent out to his edit room, which is, for example, Hindu photographer. So photographer is here and he has that model, a D750 and a D7200. Immediately he has kept the camera somewhere. He can get the image on his mobile, or he can shoot from the mobile, which actually the Chitransh is going to show you. That.
Sir, I have kept my camera here. I have my camera in this hand, and I have my all the features in this hand. So
what Chitransh is explaining is that the camera.
What I can do is, now I can keep my camera at any place and I can click with this. It will automatically click the picture and download it to my phone. So I can mail it to somebody, I can put it on social media, I can do anything with this. Sir, whatever the Wi-Fi range is, like it's good enough for this thing.
In fact, sir, the best part is that you don't have to download the very heavy file because the 24 megapixel file would give you around 30 MB file. You have an option of three small size like a VGA, a web user, like a 1200 into 800 pixel file, which easily usable for any kind of a website or any upload, you know, image it upload. So, and of course the raw file. And also similar simultaneously, like if I have this phone right now with me, that phone app, which is Nikon Mobile Utility, our own app, actually allows to check or see all the older images in the camera also. I can download the same time. So both the images are simultaneously downloading or copying in the camera card and your phone. So it's very user friendly, and then immediately you can send your images to your editor and he can do the things. Similarly,
one thing I would like to add.
Yeah.
I remember when I was shooting a bird, nesting bird. So it is logical to go very near to the nest. So what we have done is, we have kept our camera onto the tree, put all our access on our phone. So the camera was there. I can see when the bird will feed. I can see on my phone when the bird will feed, and I have captured that precious moment.
The best part is that you can focus also. Wherever he touches on his phone, that camera focuses there. So that's the best part, you cannot miss your shot. So that's also one of the very good thing you can do with the camera. Then next to the next season is basically the NFC also. The D7200 comes with the NFC technology also, that you touch and then you can have all the images copied to your files. There's one more technology has been added to the D7200. Now we'll talk about the what are the things which we have recently developed in the, all the cameras. So one is the FL flat, means the picture control, flat picture color control. All the cinema people here, all the people who are like to shoot videos or make documentaries, you must be understanding that we need a flat picture control to do the, you know, the color gradation or all the color gradation according to ourselves, you know, whatever we want to do it in the late, post-production part. So these all cameras, D810, D7200, D750, they all shoot with a flat picture control. Like you can see, this is the example on the screen if you see. We have a standard, we have a neutral, when we have a flat. So the flat is completely flat, no color, additional color gradation is to be applied, and you can easily, according to your need, you can manipulate whatever you want to do. Then again, there is again same picture control. You have a feature to make it picture more crisper. Like this is also possible to do all the other things. So clarity 1, 0, and 4, and maybe 4 will be a crisper image quality. You can see the feel of image can be changed with this tweak of a thing. This is all inbuilt. Huh? Okay. So now D810, the new technology which we have introduced is a new metering called highlight weighted metering, specially designed for the picture quality where you want to shoot. You know, most of the events where you are, you know, like a theater or any auditorium event is happening. You know, Kathak event, dance event is happening. These kind of like you can see the image quality there. So there is one image shot with the same camera with the matrix metering or any other metering, and the other one is shot with the scene provided. So scene is metered based on the brightness area. This metering does what it very nicely, that you know it handles the only brightest part of the image and then give you the exact correct exposure which you can see in the image. Then most of the cameras like D7200 also has it now. Very, very happy that this small camera can also shoot time lapses. So this time lapses is basically a number of images shot in a time duration and then combine it. Most of the people we know is that we take interval times pictures and then we combine it in a post-production. But our Nikon cameras all can do in within the camera. You have kept the camera on time lapse and then after 1 hour, you have the maybe 100, 1,000 of images, and then those images are automatically converted into a video, and you have, and you can assign the speed of like FPS, like 60 FPS, whatever you want. So this is the one of the example shot by Anurag Jaitley. He's an ex Nat Geo photographer. He has done time lapse on Delhi completely. So this basically this film called Delhi in Time Lapses. Just see and enjoy. Thank you very much. I wish the time lapse or a slow motion in post production. So this is what you can do with the all the new cameras available, like right from the D4S to the D7200.
You shoot at 60 frames per second, and you can play back slowly to get the slow motions out of it.
Okay, the new technology in terms of focusing, if you talk about, Nikon was always keen to improve the focusing so that we can have a better out-of-focus performance in all the different set of genres of photography. So the new technology, we recently came up with the new group area out-of-focusing. Till date, all the Nikon users, if you have here, we used to have a dynamic out-of-focusing system where we have to activate only one point of focusing, where generally that if you see the upper image, you're losing your focus on the subject. So that we have improved to the full activation point. Now you cannot miss any subject, any kind of movement, panning, or a straight somebody coming towards you. You can grab the focusing without any delay or anything. So this is how it works when it comes to sports photography or any other group of. Then D810 series, we also have a very unique feature for archaeological photographer or architecture photographer, people who like to shoot buildings, those kind of things, where you want to see the both corners side by side in one screen. So that is possible. We call it split screen display. So this is available with our D810 and D810A. So you can see this building, actually we can see both the corners in one go. And then we can adjust, we can plan our, we can assemble our tripod or whatever we want to do, and then we can shoot images. This is very, very handy.
Shall I add?
Yeah, please.
If suppose I have been given an assignment to click this hall, and it's where I can take that corner of the image and that corner of the image, and I can settle. So the picture you are seeing is not the full picture, it's just a corner of the images. It's good for architectural people, good for ASI people who are shooting architectural photography and indoors photography. Good for landscape people who are shooting landscape. And like, you can take two corners of the pictures and you can adjust. You can level the camera by seeing on your own, but you can't every time level see the spirit level. Right.
Thank you. So this was about the camera technology we have improved. So now when we talk about Nikkor is a brand name for the Nikkor glasses. You know, we still can use, we all know that Nikon camera is still there. We have the possibility or advantage to use our old 50-year lenses because we haven't changed our mount. So the new lineup, we have improved new version of a lenses. This is new technology, you can say. It's a Nikkor PF technology. PF is a phrase Fresnel technology where this is actually the 300mm lens. If anybody is here from the Nikon user, you can just check. This is 2470.
Sir will tell us.
This is 2470mm lens, and 2470mm lens and the 300mm lens is equal the same size.
Earlier we used to have long lenses. Sir will tell us ke kitne bhari hote the wo lenses. Now Nikon is sir is carrying. Now Nikon is working on to the compromising the size of the lenses so that we can assure the photographers.
So this is 300mm constant F4 lens, which having the PF technology and also the electronic diaphragm. So Sunil, this is the advancement, and now you can see if it's a 300mm, it's this size, which easily can be put in our pocket, you know, and we can shoot any kind of assignment with it. Imagine like new technology lenses will come up. They will also have a similar kind of, then we are short up the size of the big lenses, like for 800mm, we have 800mm, 600mm, 500mm, all those lenses can be make a small size. So we are continuously working upon those things and to make the lens smaller and good effective. So of course, this lens has a PF technology, which is provides a better results, avoid your chromatic aberrations, give you better results in low light performance or any difficult situation. So you can see one more example of your image. It can easily put in your, and this is a pro series of a lens where you can attach your teleconverters also. So please do not think that this lens will not have a advantage of attaching the teleconverters.
Yeah.
You can attach teleconverters and you can utilize for any kind of your wildlife assignment. Now, we have introduced two more new lenses called new sports VR, which actually does a very good thing for us. Now, if I show you this AV. It's not working. Sports VR. Let's have a small AV to see, and then we can just explain what is the lens it works.
Watch closely.
So if you can just see the two of the videos, the sports one is more easy and more useful for any kind of movement you want to say. We are not strict to that particular skater. We are talking about the bird. We're talking about any kind of subject material where you are shooting something, a panning. It will be an easier way to shoot. It will help you to shoot any kind of panning situation pictures. And it is available with all the new lineup DSLRs, which is coming. Nikon lenses we are coming with the 800mm, 400mm, or a new PF lens we just discussed. So with this, we conclude our presentation in terms of what we have included. We have included only the professional category here, not the the amateur or semi-professional or cool pics category that to help you out. But there are a lot of things that if you have any information, if you have any questions to be asked after this presentation, also we have a kiosk for 2 days. Please have any questions if you have with your camera. Thank you for
Malik and Mr. Saroj Dora. Shri Rajiv Malik has been heading the camera division of Sony India and has overall experience of more than 18 years. Shri Malik has been instrumental in introducing latest technology products in Indian broadcast and professional camera industry from time to time. Also, we have with us Mr. Saroj Dora, who has more than 9 years of experience in photography industry. Shri Saroj Dora has worked for commercial and advertising photography for more than 4 years. He has also worked with Hindustan Times as a photographer and technical specialist. Now with Sony and working as technical marketing officer. Over to you.
Yeah, thank you very much for giving this opportunity to interact with you, to show you the latest technologies which Sony has now. We can start with this short introductory video of Sony. Now, Sony doesn't require an introduction as such, but in the digital camera field, we were a bit late entrant. By acquiring Minolta, we became very strong in digital still photography as well. In video, we have been there for ages now. And in last 4 or 5 years, there has been a major development in Sony's digital camera technology. Assist me on that.
Yeah, thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Ever come with any other companies? So I'm just presenting one small video. So can I have the light off, please?
Sony.
So you heard about the Minolta companies. So we take over Minolta company on 2006. Now it's on Sony. So before we have on ProCam and other video cameras, but in the still cameras, now we are in Sony. So I'm just showing few features like lenses, images, image sensors and processors.
So let me add on once
yeah,
you
sure,
finish
sure,
this
please,
slide. Huh? Yeah. Image sensor, when we talk about image sensor, Sony has a legacy, one of the biggest players in the world in terms of developing image sensors from smallest size to the large size sensors. And we are one of the biggest manufacturers in the world. And the, what we want to explain is that Sony is not only focusing on image sensor, but also lenses and processors. We have our own core technologies for processors, lenses, as well as sensors. So with the complete in-house technology, we are able to develop them further based on the, with the tie-ups with world-renowned videographers and photographers. That's a constant upgradation. We are able to develop some of the very unique technologies when it comes to sensor and handling the sensor. Yeah. We can switch to.
Okay, so in lenses, we have three kind of lenses, like Zeiss. So we promote Zeiss lenses. We give the photographers to the like largest manufacturer of image sensors. So we have Exmor CMOS sensors, which is bit extra high quality sensors we providing in every camera. And about the processor, so we provide Beyond X processor, which is give you very high speed processor up to 12 frame per second, even in RAW. If you want to shoot in RAW as well, you'll get like 12 frame per second in as well RAW. So I'm moving next. So as my colleague Rajiv Ji said, we are the number one image sensor provider in the world. So I'm presenting few small palm size camera, like everybody is using heavy size camera and everybody bored with the heavy size, using the heavy cameras. So
see, everybody
we are providing like palm
to,
size small professional full sensor camera, like 7 series camera. So you can see
yeah,
this camera
this
and another
camera.
One. Another one is there.
Smallest size, and it has all the capabilities of the big DSLRs, which we all have been using for the years. With such a compact and one of the most powerful cameras available right now.
This is the 7 series camera. We have like 4 camera in this series. Let me introduce 7R, 7 and 7S. So this is very small, but it's a mirrorless technology. As I said, we are coming with new technology. So it's a mirrorless technology. There is no mirror in between the lenses and the sensor. So it's very slim, short, and easily used and very user friendly. So let me show you one video for this. Can I have the light off, please? Quick time is not available. There is no problem. There is no problem. Quick time is not available. Quick time is not available.
Forward some part.
Yeah.
There is another file.
There is another file. But this laptop, that's why. So, as you know, okay, let me explain. We have introduced one more camera, that is 7M2, which has 5-axis image stabilization. So as you know, everybody know VRIS, right? Vibration reduction, image stabilization, and we have called it optical steady shot. Sony called it optical steady shot, and we come up with the new technology and new camera, which is 5x image stabilization, which allow you like 5-axis image stabilization. So there is no, how can I see? That is the camera. This camera, right. This is the small pictures. So this camera come up with the floating sensor. It's a new, very new technology, very rare technology. This camera coming with the floating sensor. The sensor itself floated. When you shoot in the low light situation, even in the very low shutter speed, it helps you to freeze a good sharp images. So
this is a very unique technology from Sony. Usually there are 3 axes in all the cameras. 2 axes have been added in this to make it 5. Like in usual cameras, it is like yaw and pitch, left, right, up and down. Here, if you can see, not only yaw and pitch, you can move on X and Y axis, roll also. It's a floating sensor in all the direction. You can move like this, up, down, left, right, in all the direction because of floating sensor. This is a very unique technology and latest development happened in last 1 to 2 years.
Okay, so light please, I am showing with this technology how it's work. Just for interruption, I'm just changing the laptop. So I'll give you the best video images. So I'll show you the best images.
Under control. Any movement and any sort of body movement happening, it will have a minimal effect on the overall coverage. So of course, all the cameras has that. It is just one step ahead by putting some more, making the sensor floating. within the camera, the sensor part. Mm-hmm. Camera. In the camera. Yes.
Yeah, that's fine. Now you are going up.
And shabby. Help. Activity. Enable me to capture.
A lot of things, sir.
Then, I met the perfect subject. She swims like she was born in the sea. A miracle has happened in Sunset.
It's open.
Light levels were quite low. The Alpha 7S captures rich images of her dancing with a group of dolphins. This is the photograph I wasn't able to create before.
Full size が新たな光の領域へ Alpha 7S.
Let's delve into the new world of light.
Sony.
So, as you know, low lights. We have introduced one more camera, Alpha 7S, for low lights. See the next window, next window, small window next to the big window. That's on the starting level on S-Log 2, 1600 ISO. Then we are increasing the ISO. Here we go, 4,9,600 ISO. You can see the difference on 1600 ISO and 4,9,600 ISO, even no grain.
No noise at all. And one more feature, this is again 4D focus. This is again a latest technology in digital cameras, and we have come out recently with 4D focus. 4D means we have given another dimension sort of in the camera, predictive. Like motion sensing has always been there in the cameras. It is predictive motion sensing. For example, I'm moving the hand like this. Camera will be able to predict where my hand is going to go in next few 1 second or 2 seconds. So the focus cannot be lost at all because of predictive algorithm inside. So we will just touch upon that feature. It's a beautiful feature incorporated in this camera.
Light off, please. You can see the focusing point, the movement of the focusing points.
Shunji ni torae, hanasanai. 4D focus. Alpha. Sony.
Even in the video or even in the still, I'll show you the still video also. This is a very unique features ever so far. So in this feature, like you want to shoot something movable subject, and you just lock your focus somewhere and just press it half, and the focus will follow the subject wherever it goes, like corner to corner focus. We are providing, like in other body, our Sony 6000 model body, we have like 179 autofocusing point in this body. So in this body, you can use like corner to corner autofocusing points, and it's a 4D technology which predict your subject moving. So if your subject is moving from diagonal, like right to left, left to right, so it will follow the subject and give you the sharp images and better quality images.
And you can also choose to switch off also in case you don't require. But most of the times, 99% of the times, it's accurate motion sensing. It is predictable very much. And with this camera, if you see, this is the world's fastest autofocus camera. Within 0.06, it will autofocus with the change in the, you know, subject movement. With the movement, 0.06 second, fastest autofocus camera.
Now come up to RX100 model. So, yeah, please.
Quickly.
Okay, RX100 model, there is a model, small model. This is a RX10 model. It's a very compact, handy. You can carry in your pocket also, but it's a Pro series camera, and it gives, and it's come up with 2470 Carl Zeiss lens, f/2. So you can shoot any kind of subject in this camera. It's come up with 1-inch sensor and inbuilt EVF, electronics viewfinder. You can see the viewfinder itself here, and it's come up with the flash. It's a very candy camera, small camera, flash, come up with the flash with bounce facility. You can, if you want to bounce the flash, you can bounce here. So like if you want to bounce, you can bounce. So it's a very small size camera for like photojournalist or like
it has the capability of proper full-fledged DSLR compressed into a smaller size.
So it's very small. The movable tiltable LCD also, you want to shoot tiltable, you want to use the tiltable LCD, you can use here. You want to like take the selfie, you can take the selfie here. So everything can be possible with this camera. So this is the RX100 Mark III series, and we have like three SKU on this series: RX100, RX100 Mark II, and RX100 Mark III. So these are few awards for this camera we have got. Sorry, sir.
Price.
The price of the MRP of this camera is like 55,000. That's what I'm telling you. So it's a very small, handy pocket size, but professional size.
Extremely
professional
use.
Camera. Use for full frame. It's not full frame. It's a 1-inch sensor. It will produce like it's come up with 20 megapixel 1-inch sensor.
It has Wi-Fi, NFC, all built in.
ISO, you can go up to 12,800 ISO, safe zone, but the body will support you like 25,000 ISO. And come up with 50 ISO. Okay, starting ISO is 50, the best ISO is 100. Lens is 2470 Carl Zeiss, f/2. Sorry? Manual. Didn't get you. Yeah, you can. Yeah, of course. I didn't get you actually properly. You want the manual focusing?
If mic is there.
No. There is no manual focusing here. But the manual aperture here. You can control the aperture manually. Sorry? ISO. ISO maximum कितने में अच्छा आएगा? The safest zone of the ISO will be 12,800. So these are the reproduction of the Alpha 7 series cameras, which is this camera. This is also a DSLR interchangeable. You can change the lenses. The lenses, this lens is 2470 Zeiss lens. You can change. This is the sensor directly you can see. It's a mirrorless technology. Or if you come to closer, then I can show you the floating sensor also. If I shake my hand, the sensor will float.
It is visible from the outside, sensor floating with the movement. So anybody after this would like to evaluate this camera, please feel free.
So,
pardon?
We varieties of lenses, we have like 16-35, 24-70, 70-200, 55mm, 30mm, 85mm, 100mm, 135mm. So whatever lens you want to use,
we have complete
every range,
range
are there. So we are coming up to the range lenses. So speed for like journalism kind of things, you need speed, you need resolution, you need... Yeah, sure. Then. We have like two kind of lenses or mounts. One is A mount and another is E mount. Yeah? Yeah, sure.
Yeah, we are just about to finish. Just two slides more. Yeah.
Only for two slides. This is your lenses, the ranges of the lenses. These are our 6000 model, which come up with the 4D focus. We got this. So thank you. So here we will go for the question answer round. So
please feel free
is there
to
any
ask any questions. Anybody wants to have a look at the camera, please feel free.